House and Senate Intelligence Committees were just briefed on what happened in France. How concerned are U.S. officials about copycats or similar terrorist acts here in the U.S.? Let's bring in Democratic Congressman from California, Adam Schiff, who sits on the House Intelligence Committee. Congressman, thanks so much for coming by. We appreciate it. First of all, just watching Tom's report there, this was a very sophisticated attack by people who were very highly trained, it appears.
It certainly looks like they were very well trained and trained in combat, both in terms of the organization they had, but also in the ruthlessness with which they shot people, got back in their vehicles, the very methodical nature of it all. It certainly looks like they had combat experience. As of the briefing this afternoon that we received, we still don't know who's responsible. The French may be now further along than we were a couple hours ago in our own briefing. But if this is foreign fighters coming back, it will be some of our worst fears realized.
And the French government has expressed concern a number of times about the hundreds of French citizens who are fighting with rebel and terrorist groups in Syria and Iraq and then coming back. I think they put the number at 185. Have come back and come back to France. That would seem to suggest, and I know we don't know exactly who's behind this, but that might seem to suggest that this is a group that has ties to Al-Qaeda or ISIS and not just lone gunmen, three guys together coming together.
It certainly would seem that way, given the fact that this is more than one individual. It's not someone who is radicalized in their basement, but this is a group of people. And you have to wonder, if these reports out of France are correct, that they went to the wrong place first or they didn't know where they were, that might suggest there were different people casing the location from those who carried out the attack. So still a lot of unanswered questions about how many people were involved. We're obviously cooperating in every way we can with the French. We're going to provide them. If they have leads, we'll chase them down on our end, see if we have any intel on the suspects or who they may be associated with. Full extent of our forensic capabilities to the FBI will be made available any way we can to help.
Obviously nothing conclusive yet, but our intelligence officials leaning towards either AQAP or ISIS, but those are both groups that I know have been suspected in being part of this.
As of a couple hours ago, they really weren't ready to say that there are more indications of this group than that. But anyway you slice it, we're seeing a proliferation of attacks around the world. Some very unsophisticated people in a car mowing people down, others a little more sophisticated. But these are all quite low tech. And the reality is, no matter how good our intelligence may be or the Europeans' intelligence may be, it's hard to detect these low tech kind of attacks and prevent them. We're going to have to obviously step up our game. And for the French, this is not just an issue of keeping track of the hundreds of French who've joined the fight, but the many thousands of Europeans that have joined the fight that can come back to France with very easy travel in Europe.
Very open borders there. How concerned are U.S. officials about either a related attack in the United States or a possible copycat?
I don't think there's any indication that we have intelligence that there's a broader plot, that there were going to be simultaneous or consecutive attacks in Europe than the United States. But obviously we're concerned always with the prospect of copycat attacks. And it may very well be that this attack was motivated by attacks that were seen in Australia or elsewhere. So we certainly are concerned about it. I think we have done probably a better job in following the foreign fighters, merely though because we have so few of them to follow by comparison with Europe. So we have a security advantage with our oceans and with the fact that we haven't seen quite as much homegrown radicalism as in places like France.
And then lastly, it appears that these individuals at the magazine Charlie Hebdo were specifically targeted, assassinated even, because of what the magazine had published. Is that what intelligence officials are saying? This was very specifically aimed at these individuals?
It certainly looks like that. Obviously, this is a publication that has been the subject of not only a firebombing, but repeated threats throughout the years. There were no threats, very specific threats recently. I think the most specific threats were some years ago, but nonetheless, obviously, this is a publication that was within the sights of radicals because of the parody, the comedic nature of their content, and the fact that they take on all comers. They went after everybody. And this is one of the things that I think we have to be very concerned about, and that is the chilling impact on free speech. We saw it just recently in the United States with the whole North Korean complicity in the attacks on Sony, and now we're seeing it in a very bloody fashion in Europe, we have to concern not only about this horrible loss of life, but what it will mean in terms of free expression.
That's right. Congressman Adam Schiff, thank you so much. Appreciate your taking the time.